using Adobe After Effects 2021. I'm using standard layout, so this layout should be similar to yours. If for some reason you cannot see some panels which you can see on my screen, you can always go to Window and enable it from here. For example, Character. Now let's import our footage. Let's go to File, Import File. These two photos will be available to download in Resource tab to this class. So select them and click Import. First of all, we want to create new composition. To create new composition, we can click here or on this little icon right here. So let's click here and specify our resolution. We can set to 1920 by 1080. It's a resolution of full HD video. Let's also set to 30 frames per second. And length, I'll set to 9 seconds. And let's call it waterfall. Let's pick this image right here and left mouse click, hold and drag on timeline right here. So now we can just select our layer and press S on keyboard and size it so it will match our resolution. We can also click here by this edge and expand our screen, and also select the selection tool and move around your image as you like. So first thing which we want to do is to animate parts of this image. This effect requires to create a master composition with all effects, and then we will be able to just drop different texture to use on different parts of this image. For example, to create this kind of animation with all waterfalls, we'll need to have chunks of it. So for example, you can see that I've applied some chunk here, then here, here, and here, and here. But don't worry, we will create a one template, and then create other chunks will be a lot easier. So let's create our master template. To create this template, we want to click here to create new composition. Or you can go to Composition, New Composition. And let's call it Water Middle, because we will create this kind of chunk. And in resolution, let's set to maybe 800 and height to 1550. And these settings should be same. And let's click OK. So as you can see, we have this kind of chunk of the image. And here we can just drop our image, original image, into this composition. Now we can cut parts of the image into this piece. So basically we want to press S on keyboard and fill this whole screen with one chunk of the water. Okay, so now we've created our template. So let's go back to our main composition. I'm just gonna right click here and go to composition settings and call it main and click OK. To rename this composition, you just need to select it and press return on keyboard. Maybe let's call it template. And let's left mouse click and hold and drag into this main composition. So as you can see, this resolution is pretty big. Once again, select your composition, press S on keyboard to see the scale and size it down and make sure that it's about right size as our original waterfall. It doesn't have to be perfect because we will apply some effects which will allow us to match it better. Okay, so once we've got this composition to work, we need to click here on this solo button to see only this piece. And now let's try to animate it. To animate this waterfall, as you can guess, it should go from up to down. We will use effect called motion tile. So let's go to effects and presets. If you cannot see this panel, you can go to window and enable it from here, effects and presets. So here in effects and presets panel, we can type the name of the effect which we want. We want to use motion tile effect and choose it right here. Left mouse click and drag onto our layer to this composition on which we want to apply and release it. So with this tile center, we can animate this motion of falling down, as you can see. We can start at zero, and then we can just animate this property. And to animate something in Adobe After Effects, we want to create a keyframe. So to create a keyframe, we need to click on this stopwatch. Make sure that you've set your time cursor to the beginning of your video and click on this stopwatch to create our first keyframe. Left mouse click on it and then select this layer and press U on keyboard. It will show us our first keyframe which we created. If you are new to After Effects, you might be wondering, what is keyframe? Keyframe is a point in time which remembers the value of certain property. So in our case, this keyframe remembers this point in time, which is 0 seconds, this value, x and y, of this property tile center. As you can see, this property contains two values, basically it's x and y. If we will change this in x, it will move from left to right. And if we will change the second value, it will move from up to down. So we've created a first keyframe with the value of 0. And if we will go to the third second and change to something like 4000, and if we will compress this work area to this moment, you can also hold shift and it will stick to this moment, and press 0 on numpad, we can preview this video. As you can see, it's pretty fast animation, and this is how basically animation works. So basically from this keyframe, from 0, it goes to this keyframe with 4000. And here's a cool little tip. If you want to have a perfect loop of this falling down animation, you can just simply go to this template and then right mouse click here to go to composition settings and just remember the height of your composition. Just remember this height value which you'll set. In our case, it's 1550. So we already know this value. And we can go to main waterfall, and here we can set not 4000, or here not 4000, but 1550. And click enter. And now if I'm gonna press 0 on numpad, you can see that it's slower, but it's also the perfect loop. So this is basically how you can create a perfect loop animation to your videos. So in case if you want to create a GIF or GIF animation of any picture, you can keep in mind this technique of creating a perfect loop. In the next video, we will try to make this seamless transition. So for example, if we are gonna press mirror edge effect, it will be a lot better. As you can see, it's not that visible. It's much better than this. But we still have work to do to cover these edges. And by the way, once you'll click on this mirror edge effect, you need to double this value. Basically, it takes 2 times of the height to go back to the original place. So now we can just write 1550, multiply 2 times. And now, if I'm gonna press 0 numpad, you still will have this perfect loop, but with the mirrored edge. You can always spread these keyframes apart to slow it down if it's too fast for you. Okay, so in the next video, I'm going to show you how to hide this edge so it will not be so visible. Because if I'm gonna unsolo this layer, you can see that we have this really noticeable edge. See you in the next video. Okay, before we are going to get rid of this edge, we want to save our project because Adobe After Effects can crash from time to time. So let's go to File, Save As, and you can save it wherever you want. Okay, so to hide this kind of edge, we want to select this template which we've created and pre-compose it. So basically we want to take this composition and put inside of another composition. To do exactly that, we need to select this composition and go to Layer, Precompose. And we want to leave all attributes, which basically means that all effects which we've applied will stay in this main composition. And let's also type here template main. And make sure to click here to leave all attributes in main waterfall. And let's click OK. So now as you can see, we still have this effect which we applied. Double click on this composition. And we will see this composition which we created before. So basically, even if you will go to project panel, you can see that we have now 2 compositions. First one, we can call it template inside or template texture. If we will open this composition, you'll see that here we're gonna drop our texture. And in template main, we will fix all the issues with the edges. So let's fix these issues. To fix these issues, you can simply just select this composition and press Ctrl D to duplicate this composition. And what I want to do is to select this rectangle tool left mouse click on it, and just cut it. Just left mouse click, hold and drag to make this kind of mask. And just simply select this composition on which we applied this mask, and with this selection tool, move it up. And then you can press F on keyboard to feather this edge. We can move it even lower or spread this mask a bit so it will not feather from the sides and just from the bottom. And basically, as you can see, if I'm changing this value, it's feathering the edge, which will make this transition more smoother. So before and after. As you can see, we are trying to create this seamless texture. Same thing we can do with the bottom. We can just select this bottom composition, press Ctrl D to duplicate, and also select this rectangle tool and cut this part of the image, lower part. And also let's press F on keyboard and let's set it to 300 maybe. So we would feather the edge, and then we can just select this selection tool and move it down. You can also hold shift. As you can see, I'm holding shift. It will allow you to move this composition down only in one axis, which is really handy. And now, as you can see, we have this kind of seamless texture. And if we will go with the main waterfall, you can see that now, when it's falling, it looks a lot more seamless. You can always pick this moment where you can see your seam and just adjust a bit in this template main composition and go back and make sure that it's not too noticeable. But don't worry too much, because also I'm going to show you how you can cover these imperfections. The main thing which we wanted is to create this cool looking texture which resembles with the original photo. And as you can see, it looks really cool if we unsolo this layer. Okay, so now we have this animation, but we still have these ugly edges which doesn't work with our effect. And this time we cannot just simply use this rectangle tool like we did before to cut this composition, because as you can see, if I'm gonna press to this solo button, this is why we cannot use the mask, because this effect of motion tile will create these kind of problems. So let's delete our mask and use instead effect called linear wipe. So let's type it here, linear wipe. Just make sure to select this transition linear wipe effect and drag to our main template. And now with this effect, we can cut our image, as you can see. With this, we can set the direction for the cut, and we want to cut from the sides a bit and feather the edge. Feather is good to set about to 155. As you can see, it blends better. And then just cut so you would not see this edge. So something like this, like 14, should work fine. We can also select this linear wipe and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. We can just flip this angle to minus 90, which basically is the opposite effect from this side. And we can cut it even more if you want. And it's up to you how much you want to cut of this texture. We need to also cut from top and bottom. So let's duplicate one more time, select this linear wipe effect and press Ctrl D and set this angle to 0. As you can see, it will cut from the bottom. And here it's better to use higher value, so it will blend better at the bottom of our image. So let's finally duplicate one more time and set this angle to 180, which means that it will cut from the top. Now, as you can see, we have set our fade from all sides. And if we will unsolo this layer by clicking here, you can see that it blends a lot better. And we can just simply left mouse click and place it wherever you want. Okay, so as you can see, it looks pretty good. But we have one problem. We would want to have this kind of arc motion. And now it looks too straight. It falls too straight, and we want to have this arc kind of motion. And this arc motion I'm going to show you in the next video. See you in the next video. Okay, so as you can see, we have this really cool animation which has this perfect loop, but we still have some work to do, because we want to add this kind of arc motion. So for this we want to use puppet tool. Just locate it here, left mouse click, and then select this main template. Once again, it's better to click here to solo this layer to see the edges, and you can basically just create 6 points. For example, here, here, here and here, here and here. Just make sure to create these points in visible parts of your image. Then you need to select this layer and press U on keyboard, because as you can see, it creates these keyframes. We don't want to have a keyframes, just select them and press delete. And now we can just simply go to this selection tool and move around our image as we like. Just make sure if you moved all your image, press Ctrl Z and then select any parts of the image, then select puppet tool, and then it will allow you to change only one point, just like this. It cuts this edge, and this is a problem. To fix this problem, we need to go to this effect controls panel and click here under puppet effect, which we've used, this checkbox, which basically will cut this edge. And as you can guess, now we can just make this any kind of motion which we like. So we can just go out from this solo mode and adjust our flowing effect as we like. Once again, select this composition. If you cannot see the points, then select your puppet effect, and then you should be able to see these points. And now we can even drag up and stretch this as you like. You can always press S on keyboard to make this size larger or smaller. As also, you can just simply select this puppet tool and stretch your effect just like this. So as you can see, with this effect, you can give some kind of arc motion, as well as this spreading at the bottom, if you want. Just don't go overboard, because it will be noticeable. You just want to have this little hint, like it's bending. And once again, with this linear wipe effect, you can always cut the edges which you can see, so you will not see these kind of lines in your image. You just need to refine this linear wipe effect. As I'm changing it, it fades away. And finally, just you can increase the scale and fit your image properly. Just make sure to cut all of the edges so they would not be so visible. So this is how you can add this kind of curvy motion effect. We can also increase the scale and move it down and press 0 on numpad to see the preview. In the next video, I'm going to show you how it's easy to use this template and create another patch of this image. See you in the next video. Okay, so now once we've created this template, it will be a lot easier to create other parts of this image. So now we can just go to project panel and duplicate these both compositions. So let's select both of them and press Ctrl D. Now we can just rename it, this main one. We can rename it to right, because we are going to use this part of the image. You can name it wherever you want, so you could understand which parts of the image you named. So in my case, I'm just gonna call it water right, because this right part, and also this copy with the two, I'm going to rename it to right. And this is how easy it is to use. You can just select this texture composition and simply just move to the left to get this different kind of texture. You can also increase the scale. You can even press R on keyboard to rotate it, because your main idea here in the texture to get the texture which goes one direction. Because if you're gonna set it like this, let me show you on this example with our original example. Don't repeat this part. I just want to show you what happens if you're gonna set texture in our texture template. As you can see, it will get this kind of other kind of look. In some cases, it might work even more interesting, so it is up to you how you want to use it. But my advice is to set to the texture composition as straight texture as you can. So something like this should work fine. As you can see, it works better. And here, want to use straight texture. So in my case, I want to rotate it to -2 to get this straight lines of the water. Then I want to use this right template main and just swap this texture with the new texture which we got. So simply you just need to left mouse click and select all of them. Then select this new texture which we've created for right template and left mouse click. Hold Alt on keyboard. As you can see, I'm holding Alt. And make sure that you've selected these ones and this one. While holding Alt on keyboard, you just need to left mouse click, hold and drag on top of these textures. It will swap this texture, as you can see. Once I've released it, it replaced the texture. And now we can just simply go to main waterfall and duplicate this main template just by selecting it and pressing Ctrl D. Same thing we want to do here. We just need to select this one which we moved to the right, this texture, and replace it with this right template main. Just hold it, left mouse click and hold, hold Alt on keyboard and place it on top of this composition, which also needs to be selected. And it will swap this texture. And now as you can see, we have these both animations. But keep in mind that you will need to go to Effects and Controls and adjust this puppet tool. The easiest way to adjust it is just simply to reset it and then create another curve which you like, if you want to curve in different kind of way. Because for future example which you're gonna see in this class, we will want to curve in much different ways to get these kind of looks in other images. So with this puppet tool, we will always able to change direction of this flow. As you can see, we are getting somewhere. It looks pretty cool, but we can increase this look. First of all, we can just use sharpen effect and just drop it on this one and set it to maybe 150 to get this sharpness into our water. We can copy it, press Ctrl C, and select the second one and press Ctrl V to paste it. So this will increase the visibility of each water drop, which will look even cooler. In the next video, I want to show you how you can get the sense of depth in this water. So if you will pay attention, you can see that here you have some droplets which falls really fast and some falls not so fast. And this increases this depth feeling of this water. And I'm going to show you how to do exactly that in the next video. See you in the next video. Okay, so now to create this kind of sense of depth in our image, we can simply just use one of these textures. For example, let's use this left one. We can just select it, as you can see it's left one, and press Ctrl D to duplicate. And just simply with this puppet tool, we can stretch this texture. I know that at this point it could look a bit ugly, and by the way, you can always select one of these points and press delete to delete them. So let's delete this one too, select this composition and press S on keyboard, click on this lock button which will allow us to stretch it in X axis. As you can see, we are stretching it just like this, and with this puppet tool we can adjust this stretch. So let's also solo this layer to see what we are doing, and let's stretch it a bit even further. Okay, and now with the linear wipe effect, we just want to make sure that we don't see these edges. Just make sure to cut all of these edges and then unsolo this layer. And the main idea is to change the transfer mode, because now it's too visible and it looks pretty ugly. So we need to go to this toggle switches and modes, click here until you'll see this mode effect. So you can click it here and let's change to lighten. And as you can see, it looks much better. And if you're gonna set this resolution to quarter, so your computer will handle this animation, and press 0 on numpad, it looks better, but still doesn't have this kind of depth. And to create this depth, you just need to press U on keyboard and change this second value to higher value, so these drops will fall a lot faster. So for example, we can set it to 4500 and click enter. And now if I'm gonna press 0 on numpad, you'll see this kind of sense of depth. And it's up to you to change it to lesser value like 4000 and get the animation which you like. At this point you can see that we have this kind of stretchy motion, but keep in mind that once you'll render your footage, it will be in full. And as you can see, quality is much better. But it's better to work in quarter, so you could see faster your preview. And now I want just to fix this stretching part, because it's too stretched out. And always you can fix these edges. Then set your resolution to full and press 0 on numpad to see your final result. You can always drag your footage to the left to get a bit kind of different moment of your texture and stretch this keyframe apart. And then press 0 on numpad to see our preview. And as you can see, we have this more sense of depth in our waterfalls. And basically with this template we can create more of this kind of flowing action. In the next video I'm going to show you how it is easy to use the same template with the different image. See you in the next video! And now I just want to show you how it is easy to use this same template which we've created to different kind of images. So let's create another composition, let's call it smoke. It should be also Full HD or any resolution which you like, and click OK. And let's drop it this photo with the smoke. And let's size it down. And basically now once we have this kind of template, we can just simply select these two compositions with the main and texture and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. We need just to rename it to the smoke, so we would know that it's for smoke. And this one as well, with the number 2, we need to rename it to the smoke. And now we can just close this composition and go to main waterfall. Simply we need just to copy one of these layers. Not the stretch one, but just the side one. For example, let's copy this right one. Let's press Ctrl C and go to the smoke composition and press Ctrl V. Because here it has all our preset which we want. Then we can just open it and select all of these three layers and swap it with the smoke texture. Let's swap it. To swap it, we need to select these three compositions, then select this composition here, hold Alt, left mouse click and drop it here on top. And then just open it, because now we have the smoke texture, but we just need to drop this image into it. So let's go with this smoke one and drop it here. And once again, you just need to set your smoke inside of this composition using rotation and scale. So press S for scale to make it this size larger and R to rotate it to get to this straight line as I've recommended in previous videos. So something like this should work fine. We can see that it's changed to this smoke effect. Just make sure that you worked in this smoke main. Let's open it and let's drop it this texture smoke in this smoke main one. And then let's go to the smoke. And now as you can see, we already have this effect. Once again, we just need to go to the puppet and reset it, so it will get this simplest form of this smoke. Then let's see the direction it goes from top to bottom. In our case, we want it to go from right to left. So let's select it and press R on keyboard. We can just simply rotate to match the texture. As you can see, this bright spot needs to be on top. So let's set it just like this. It matches pretty well. And as you can guess, we want to have these two patches here to get this part. So let's set it about here, just like this. Once again, we can go to the solo mode by clicking here and adjust these edges so it will cut all unwanted parts. We can always go to scale by pressing S and make it larger to cover more of this. We can reduce the sharpness or just disable it, and we can get this kind of result. And press U on keyboard, select both of these keyframes, because now you can see that it goes from left to right. And we want to go from right to left, like it is going from here to the left. So to do the opposite of the motion which we already have, We need to press U on keyboard to see these keyframes, select them, and then right mouse click on one of them and go to the keyframe assistant and choose time reverse keyframes. And now, as you can see, it goes in opposite direction, which is exactly what we want. And basically, you can just duplicate this same composition and move it here and use it as is. Or you can once again duplicate here, open the texture composition and use different part of this image to get the different texture. Then open this main with the second one, swap it as we did before, and go to this smoke composition and swap it with new one. And in this case, you'll get another kind of smoke. And now, as you can see, we're getting this same kind of effect, which looks pretty cool. And finally, as you remember, you can just duplicate one of these compositions, press S on keyboard, click here to unlock this button, and stretch it out just like this. Just don't stretch too much, because it can look ugly. And you can always go to this puppet tool, adjust how this smoke will behave. So, for example, you can go with this kind of curved look.